Welcome back to Sister Circle Live, and as we continue to celebrate our third year, we're also celebrating our growth since we've started here down to the circle. Today, we're shining the spotlight on our sister, Trina Braxton. Take a look.
I just made my first year at Sister Circle, and I'm so excited to be part of the family.
Let's welcome our new sister to the show, Trina Braxton! Yeah!
At first, it wasn't easy being the new girl on the block at Sister Circle because everybody already had their positioning. And I was like, oh gosh, I don't want to step on their toes because as entertainers, a lot of us do a lot of the same things. And it took me a second to kind of find my niche, but the ladies made it so easy. They embraced me. They said, Trina, you just be you. Everyone's free to be themselves. And they just made it so easy for me to blossom and grow and just be who I am.
Great job, Trina.
Thank you.
Trina, now, it's funny how you got this dance down pat.
Yes.
You can't get the shoe.
As a little girl, I was born, bred, and buttered to be in the entertainment industry. We grew up in the church. We weren't part of the choir. We were the choir. So we were always in front of people. And when we were younger, we would always be on the video camera, interviewing each other, being talk show hosts, creating things, and always just being entertainers. And it was just a great segue for my life to be a part of Sister Circle and becoming a television host.
That command staff had reportedly encouraged officers to target black people in order to clear cases. I'm sorry. I'm just going to just jump right on.
Go right ahead.
I was not developed in my role as a talk show host. I was very nervous. I was very settled in being a sister with the Braxtons, and I had to kind of break myself out of that norm. And once I finally did, I discovered a different side of myself, and it allowed me to blossom into my own woman, into my own self, into my own purpose, into my own decisions.
Tony thinks she's Lil' Kim.
Really?
What?
It's a really crazy thing, being on the opposite side of the couch and interviewing a member of my family.
I have to keep my job to wise up.
Yes. Okay.
Especially trying to ask a question that I don't know the answer to.
But Tracy, let's talk about you for a minute. This is your moment.
It just kind of makes it more fun because we still have that engagement with each other, but it still gives each of us that individualism that we need at that time.
Sometimes there's not necessarily anything like really wrong, or you just might be stressed out, or you just don't really feel like it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
How do you shake that off? Yeah.
Well, sometimes, you know, you have to move according to how you feel, and other times you have to just kind of move even when you're not feeling it.
It's been a tough year. It really has. And my push through allows that woman to get out of bed, because it was very difficult to do that. I had to kind of inspire myself. I had to encourage myself, because wallowing in self-pity was not going to help me, wasn't going to help my children. I'm still growing through it. I'm still learning through it. I'm not going to get emotional. I'm still praying through it. I'm still foraging through it. And right now, that's all I have to say about it.
To the newly engaged Trina and Vaughn. Congratulations!
You have to allow yourself to go through the stages of life, whether it's love lost, whether it's love gained. And you can't allow yourself to embrace the new love that's gained unless you allow yourself to get past the love that's lost. And I couldn't love Vaughn fully until I had to allow myself to let go of the love that I had in the past.
One more time.
Put some glutes out, all right?
Woo! I love it. Y'all got this.
Yeah!
Oh! We're gonna make it.
The slenderization process is a roller coaster. Sometimes I'm fat, sometimes I'm thin. Sometimes I want to eat, sometimes I don't. And Vaughn doesn't make it easy because sometimes he wants pizza and I need a salad.
He had two slices and then I want another slice. I'm like...
But did you eat, though?
I took a few bites.
Okay, it's fine.
But right now, I'm sticking to my guns. I'm getting up, I'm going to the gym, and I'm trying to eat right.
Here is good wherever you can go.
Is that the alternate Trina? Look at
that. And that's the alternate.
Sister Circle has given me so many gifts, but I think the biggest gift that Sister Circle has given me is the gift of individualism.
You are glowing, my love. Yes, you are.
What's happening?
What's happening? That's her laugh.
She's the bougie Brex.
There is no such thing as a bougie Brex. Yeah, we're all fun.
This is the booty.
Our booty.
Booty.
It's the
guys.
Yes.
Wow, beautiful. That was so good.
I see y'all tried to take me out, but I wasn't gonna let you.
We took all of us out.
All three of us.
Great job. How you feel?
Oh, you know, I feel blessed because being here has been one of the best experiences I've ever had in my entire life.
Wow.
I look forward to getting up in the morning and coming to work.
Yes.
Because it's not a job.
Yes.
I get to spend time with my family every day.
Right, right. Well, thank you so much for just being exactly who you are. And we love every little piece of it.
Isn't it good?
It's so good.
It's so good.
Even the wobbly bits.
Great job to our entire team. Sheree, you did your thing once again. Selena is tomorrow. We're looking forward to seeing that. We'll be right back.